Okay, sorry about the delay in the videos, but I have a child graduating tomorrow, and so the month of May has been a little crazy. So, we're gonna jump into Zephaniah chapter 3. And before we jump into that, I want to remind you that when God gave the message to Zephaniah to deliver, he did not have it divided up into chapter and verses. So, and when Zephaniah wrote it down, he did not have it divided up into chapter and verses. These are divisions that we have put in this book to help us navigate it. Okay. So when you read the scriptures, when you read a book, make sure that you read it in that context and with that understanding. And so when we look at Zephaniah chapter 2, the end of Zephaniah chapter 2 is focusing on the nation of Assyria and the city of Nineveh. But as we move in to where we have divided chapter 3, verse 1, we see the thought change, the focus changes. It moves away from Assyria and it comes back to Jerusalem, to Judah, to the nation of Israel. And so chapter 3 begins with, "Woe to her who is rebellious and defiled, the tyrannical city. She heeded no voice. She accepted no instruction. She did not trust in the Lord. She did not draw near to her God. Her princes within her are roaring lions. Her judges are wolves at evening. They leave nothing for the morning. Her prophets are reckless, treacherous men. Her priests have profaned the sanctuary. They have done violence to the law. The Lord is righteous within her. He will do no injustice. Every morning he brings his justice to light. He does not fail. But the unjust knows no shame." So now here we have God delivering a message through Zephaniah, letting the people know that the nation as a whole is not trusting the Lord. The nation as a whole is not accepting instruction from him. And the leaders of that nation have not been serving the people or serving the Lord. They are out for themselves. And even the priests and the prophets of the people are not heeding the instructions of God. And they're even using the law, using the precepts and commands of God to do violence. Does it sound familiar? Does it? But then through Zephaniah, God reminds us that he is righteous. Even in the midst of that, even when there are others who are leaders and claiming to be prophets and priests, and even when they defile the law of God and the word of God and the city of God and the people of God, God looks at us and he says, "But I am still righteous within her." They may have been manipulating and twisting and distorting and manipulating with my word and with my commands, but if you will look to me, I have not changed. I have not changed. I do no injustice. And every morning, he brings his justice to light. So God is like, "Look, stop looking at them and look to me. Look to me. You can trust me. The unjust knows no shame, but God is just." All right? So look to him. He is righteous and he never forsakes that righteousness. You can count on him. You can trust him. And he does not fail. I love how he reminds us of that. And then he goes on and he begins to remind the people, he says, "I have cut off nations. Their corner towers are in ruins. I have made their streets desolate with no one passing by. Their cities are laid waste without a man, without an inhabitant. I said, 'Surely you will revere me. You will accept instruction. So her dwelling will not be cut off according to all that I have appointed concerning her.' But they were eager to corrupt all their deeds." So God is like reminding the nation of Israel, the people of Jerusalem and Judah right now, that's like, look, if you will not heed instruction, if you will not come underneath my justice and underneath my righteousness, then I will deal with this. I will address this. And look at all the other nations that have already been addressed. Even look to your sister, the northern kingdom of Israel, Assyria, who God used Assyria to come in and to deal with because they would not accept the instruction of the Lord. So, but then we move in to verse 8. It says, therefore, wait for me, declares the Lord, for the day when I rise up as a witness. Indeed, my decision is to gather nations, to assemble kingdoms, and to pour out on them my indignation, all my burning anger, for all the earth will be devoured by the fire of my zeal. Therefore, wait for me. So through Zephaniah, God is calling out not to a nation, but to the individuals within that nation. And he's saying, wait for me. I know it doesn't look fair. I know it doesn't look right. I know it looks like you have been forsaken. I know it looks like you have been forgotten. I know it looks like I am not real to you, but wait for me. I will rise up as witness. I see. I am the God who sees. I am the God who hears. I am the God who knows. I am sovereign. I will deal with this. I will one day rise up and I will gather and assemble and I will pour out. Justice will be made because he is righteous within her. Whether it be in the nation of Israel or any other nation on this earth, because he says for all the earth. He's not just God of a particular nation. He is God of the universe. So he says, wait for me. Trust me. Trust my instruction. Trust my word. Know that I am righteous. Know that I am just. Know that one day all wrongs will be made right. One day. Therefore, wait for me, declares the Lord, for the day when I rise up as witness. Wait for him, okay? He's good. He's so good. I'm going to stop there, and then we'll move in to verse 9.